really believe that whatever you do is formulating your way of thinking. And with that thinking, you translate it to whatever. And initially, somebody thinks it's important if it's called art or craft or whatever. I don't have that, you know, distinction. We are at my new studio, or actually my first studio. I never had a working studio before. I really believe in an empirical touch on observation of the situation, the space, or whatever you deal with. And the process in Gyllenhof is also similar. It's really like, I mean, it was too big to have like a master plan of what happens. And I think it's actually much more about cleaning up the space. And that's what we have done. When I was younger, I could travel around the world. I would have 3 around the world tickets at the same time, you know. And I just don't have that energy anymore. And I mean, it was doing all these travel was a very important education for me. But I think you change with age, and I think it's just a moment where I need like to be able to observe seasons. And I was born in Denmark, where we have extreme seasons, and I never noticed it. And in an age of 45, that's when I start to engage with it, and I think it's time to do so. Everybody's born under systems, whether it's social, political. Somebody has created like what you should do and think, you know, and I'm very skeptical towards that, and I have always tried to find what rules fits to me, to oneself, right? And that was why I always in the art practice were putting things that seemingly was contradictions, but I think contradictions are very real in everybody's life. But we learn like this weird thing that it should be harmonious, which it rarely is, you know. And I question today even that if that is a quality in itself. And I really learned through the practice to embrace contradiction. That's what we live with, you know. In all problems that exist, they come within oneself. And I always said that one has to set trap for yourself, because the desires that you think you have is mostly brought up by somebody else, or controlled by, or delivered by somebody else. And I think that's why I always said that one have to put these traps up, because you have to trap yourself, because these desires you have is the problem in itself. And I must admit, I have beautiful places I can go to, but I ended up between a chicken farm and a compost station. And I think that is the reality, you know. And I learned that from actually Isamu Noguchi, that he built it like his paradises within all the problems of things. And I think that is intriguing for me. Totem was a very important piece for me. It was a kind of weird ambition. Can you deal with one's grandmother and make that important, you know? How far can it go out? And I think also it was a time where people were talking about me expressing my cultural background as a Vietnamese. But for me it was really to take these objects that was a very Western projection of what it means to be leaving everything behind you for a dream that's totally abstract. when I did Oma Totem, nobody knew about my work. Very few people. I had like good support, but it was not many, you know. And I loved this idea. And in reality, I never see myself as a creative person. I see myself as a very practical person. And I went to art school, and I was thinking, okay, if I'm gonna become an artist, I'm gonna deal with these white cubes around the world, around different places. And what does that mean? How do you extract the best quality out of it? And the best quality out of it is that it was designed and constructed to decapitate relations, meaning that it was isolating objects from real world. And I thought, let's make use of that. And when I did Uma Totem, I don't think it was the first piece, but there was other pieces related to that. I thought actually, when people would come as a strange visitor, they would be just estranged. They wouldn't understand what this would be. My captions at the time was very terse and short and concrete. No? There was no intimacy revealed. I mean, it would mention my grandmother's name and whatever, but I wasn't interested in intimacy. I was interested in the distance between different social groups, gender, whatever. That I wanted to deal with the estrangement when you would come in a white cube where informations are amputated, that you would just not understand. Because I think that is reality. You know, like there's all this bullshit that art is bridging. I don't believe in that. I think art should estrange, you know? I went to church every Sunday until I was 18 years. I hate, still today, Easter because I had to go to church 3 times a week. You had to go Friday, Thursday, or whatever, Sunday. And I hated that because I knew that they would never approve my, or I learned that they never would approve my sexuality or lifestyle. So it didn't fit me. You know? I think that when you have a problem, you have to deal with it. And you have to confront it. And I think actually through working with religious sculptures, I got to really appreciate it. I think the best art reviews and connections I've had is with the church. They, you know, like I have this very strange relationship with, you know, religious people that actually really appreciate my work. You know, like one of the main things in Catholicism is that you have to doubt. And there is a lot of connection points. It's just like the sculpture. You think things doesn't fit, but they actually can do very well. You can make them fit. You know, somebody told me that art happens when it's needed. I think that's very true. It's abstract, but I think it's very true. I think, you know, like, I think terminologies, definitions are fluid, you know? I think when the word freedom became estranged from me was when the Western world went to war in the name of freedom. Then you have like to rethink what freedom means for you. And I think that's the same, that function, when you talk about what an artist's role means, you know. If art today, as we see it, is a commodity, then I think you have to use that terminology as a Trojan horse. So what I'm saying is that my job as an artist is do whatever I'm doing. But when it functions, that is not the artist's responsibility, but that depends on simple thing as if the museum would be free for everybody, or if a museum would be placed not in the center of a city, but in the suburb, you know? What does these kind of things mean? And I think that comes, that's the responsibility of the society, not from the artist.